Welcome students for the VIP image enhancement second part, that is histogram processing. Histogram of a digital image with gray levels in the range of 0 to L minus 1 is a discrete function of a form h of rk is equal to nk, where rk is the kth gray level and nk is the number of pixels in the image having the gray level rk. The normalized histogram P of RK is equal to NK divided by N, where K having the range from 0 to L minus 1. P of RK gives the estimation of the or estimate of the probability of occurrence of the gray level RK. The sum of all components of the normalized histogram is equal to 1. So the histogram are the simple plot of h of rk, that is histogram of rk is equal to nk, that is nk versus rk. So these are the some images having the different contrast level and its histogram plot. So suppose this is the dark image, so the histogram at the left hand side. If this is a bright contrast image, so the histogram is the opposite of the first image, so which is in right hand side. This is the third image, is a low contrast image, so this is the middle histogram is middle side, and this is the high contrast image, so the there is a long histogram plot. So in the dark image, the components of the histogram are concentrated on the low or dark side of the grayscale. So the left hand side is the dark scale of the grayscale. In case of the bright image, the histogram components waste towards the high side of the grayscale. So in the second image, so it is the high side of the grayscale. The histogram of the low contrast image will be narrow and will be concentrated towards the middle of the grayscale. So low contrast image is at the histogram is at the middle level, middle side of the grayscale, and the components of the histogram in the high contrast image covers the broad range of the grayscale. So high contrast image covers the broad range of the grayscale. The net effect of this will be an image that shows the great degree of gray levels details and high dynamic range. So the next one is the histogram equalization. It is nothing but S is equal to transformation of R, where R should be lies between 0 to 1, and R is equal to inverse transform of S. Histogram equalization, that is S is equal to transformation of R, where R should be in the 0 to 1, and R is equal to, if you evaluate the R, that is you have to take inverse transform of S, that is S should be 0 to 1, right? So the histogram equalization is the common technique for enhancing the appearance of the images. The suppose we have an image which is predominantly dark, then its histogram would be skewed towards the lower end. So lower end. So if the dark end, dark image is there of the grayscale, and the image details are compressed into the dark end of the histogram, as we already checked in the histogram plot. If we could scratch out the gray levels at the dark end to produce the more uniformly distributed histogram, then the image would become more clear. Suppose there be a continuous function of R being gray level of the image to be enhanced. So the range of R should be 0 to 1, that is 0, 1. With the R is equal to 0 representing the black and R is equal to 1 representing the white. The transformation function is the form. Then S is equal to transformation of R, where R should be 0 to 1. It produces the levels of S for every pixel value of R in the original image. And the transformation function is assumed to fulfill two conditions. T of R is the single valued and multiplicatively increasing from the interval 0 to 1, and R should be 0 to 1. That is, if R is equal to 0, the black, and R is equal to 1, then will be the white. The transformation function should be single valued so that the inverse transformation should be exist. and the monotonically increasing condition preserves the increasing order from the black to white in the output image. And the second condition, that the output gray level will be the same range as in the input gray levels. The gray levels of the image may be viewed as a random variables in the interval 0 to 1. And the most fundamental descriptor of the random variable, it is probability function P of R and P of S, that is a probability density function of random variable R and S. So P of R is nothing but the PDF function of R, and P of S is nothing but the PDF function of S. And the basic result from an elementary probability theory status, if P of R is equal and T of R are known and T minus N of S satisfy the condition, that is the remaining one, then the probability density function of formed variable S is given by the formula. Probability density function PR of R, that is with respect to DR by DS, that is PDF of transformed variable DS, is determined by the gray levels of the PDF of the input image by the chosen transformation function. The transformation function particularly important in the image processing because S is equal to T of R if the integration with respect to 0 to R, P of R of W of W, is this is the cumulative distributive function of R using the definition of T, that derivatives of S with respect to the R. So this is the cumulative distributive function CDF. That is substituting back to this formula. So you will get the PS of S, that is a probability density function, S is equal to 1. An important point is here is that TR depends upon the PR of R, but resulting PS of S is always uniform because its value is 1 and independent of PR of R. The discrete values we deal with the probability and summations instead of the probability density function and integrals. So the PR of R is equal to, this is your histogram formula, NK divided by N, where N is the total number of pixels in the image, NK is the number of pixels that have the gray value of RK. So NK is the pixel value and it's have the gray value level of RK. L is the total number of possible gray levels. So L is the total number of possible gray levels. So K will be starts from 0 to L minus 1. For the discrete function. So SK is equal to transformation of RK, which is function of J is equal to 0 to K PR of RJ, that is summation J is equal to 0 to K NJ divided by N for the possible values of K from 0 to L minus 1. Thus the processed image is obtained by mapping each pixel with the levels RK in the input image and into the corresponding pixel with the level SK in the output image. So in the histogram, whatever the input levels having the value RK, that will be correspondingly processed the output value pixel of SK in the output image. So plot, that is histogram plot, is nothing but the RK versus NK. We can call it as a histogram plot. Here should be NK. The transformation function given by the above equation is called as the histogram equalization or linearization. This function is called as the histogram equalization or linearization. So the given image and image, the process histogram equalization consists of simple implementation of transformation function, which is based information that can be extracted directly from the given image without any need for the further parameter specification. And in case of the equalization, automatically determines the transformation function that seeks to produce an output image that has uniform equalization, that means PS of S is equal to 1, and it is a good approach when automatic enhancement is needed. So automatic enhancement is needed where that the histogram can be used, that is histogram equalization or linearization. And in the equalization, the transformation, automatic equalization automatically determines the transformation function which produces the output image and which has the uniform histogram. So these four figures have the different histogram, that is the dark side, so the histogram, contrast, low, high contrast, low contrast, and the gray levels. So these are the respective histogram. These are the transformation function from 1 to 4 where the obtained from the histogram in the image. So previous image. So the next one is the histogram matching or specification. In some cases it may be desirable to specify the shape of the histogram that we wish the processed image to have. So the histogram equalization does not allow the interactive image enhancement. So in the histogram equalization, the interactive image enhancement is not there and generates only one result. That is an approximation to the uniform histogram, whether it is a uniform histogram or not. The sometimes we need to able to specify a particular histogram shape. So we have to analyze the particular histogram shape, and that is capable of highlighting the certain gray levels ranges. So that is nothing but the highlighting some gray level ranges. The method is used to generate the processed image that specifies the histogram. It's called as a histogram matching or histogram specific. So in histogram matching or histogram specification, we have to highlight the some certain gray level ranges. And for the gray level ranges, we have to enhance only that area. So that is nothing but the histogram matching or histogram specification. And it is given by the normal formula S is equal to TR of R, that is integration 0 to R PR of W with respect to W. That is GZ is equal to, if you convert into Z transform, so you will get the S. So PZ of Z is the desirable PDF. So this is the our previous formula which is converted into the Z domain. So SK plot with respect to mapping with the ZA. Next one is the how histogram matching algorithm can be developed. So first of all, compute SK is equal to PF of K for the K value 0 to L minus 1, that is the cumulative normalized histogram of frequency. After that, GK, compute the GK for the same K value 0 to L minus 1. The transformation function from the given histogram HZ. So convert into the HZ. After that, compute G minus K1 of SK for each value of K using the interactive methods. And after that, compute the F using the G minus 1 F of K. So this is the histogram matching or specification formula. This is the image of Mars moon photon taken by the NASA and its histogram. The next one, the transformation function for the histogram equalization. The same image is for the different histograms and its mapping. Next is the local enhancement. The local enhancement. Let us start with the local enhancement. In earlier methods, the pixels were modified by the transformation function based on the gray levels of an entire image. But it is not suitable when enhancement is done in the small areas of the image. Okay. So in earlier method, the transformation is done on the entire image depending upon the gray levels. But some application it is not suited. So local enhancement can be removed this problem. So this problem can be solved by the local enhancement, where transformation function is applied only in the neighborhood of the pixel in interested region. So we can apply the enhancement function for the interested region. Define the square or rectangular neighborhood or mask and move the center from the pixel to pixel. So you can move the center from the pixel to pixel. The histogram using the local function, for example 7x7 neighborhood. Okay, so this is the histogram function. This is the first one is the original image. Second one is the result of global histogram equalization. Third result is the result of the local histogram using the 7x7 neighborhood about the each pixel. For each neighborhood, calculate the histogram of the point in the neighborhood. Obtain the histogram equalization and specification. Map the gray level of pixel concentrated in the neighborhood. And the shift to the center or the center of neighborhood region is in then moved to the adjacent pixel location, and procedure is repeated. So in this way, the histogram can be used. The histogram statistics for the image enhancement, where the R denotes the discrete random variable, P of R denotes the normalized histogram component corresponding to the ith value, and its mean will become m is equal to summation I is equal to 0 to l minus 1 r I into its p of r I. The nth movement can be calculated by this formula, and second nth movement, that is raised to 2, can be calculated by this formula. Global enhancement means the global mean and variance are matched over an entire image, and the local enhancement means the local mean and variance are used as the basis for making changes. So thank you for up to this. So in next part, image enhancement next part, we are going to check the different operations performed. Arithmetic operation and logical operation are used for the image enhancement. Thank you.